Hello, welcome to Mouse Cheers.
Cheers.
It's great to see you, Andrew.
Great to see you. How have you been?
I've been really good. Just had something on my mind.
Uh-huh.
I've had something on my mind. I can't shake it.
Let's hear it.
I want to talk about hide and seek.
The last time I played hide and seek, let me tell you. I couldn't even tell you if I was good at it. Do you happen to know if you were good at hide and seek?
I think I'm fantastic at it. Here's why. Well, you see, when you're a child, you play hide and seek. You know, when you're a parent, you play hide and seek. I don't play hide and seek, not yet. My son is just turned a year old. But when you get like older, like high school age, you start playing like Manhunt. You ever play Manhunt?
I have played Manhunt. I've played Manhunt like the kind of Manhunt you can't play today. Like,
yeah, like you're out. It's dark. That's the point. You're outside. You're going in other people's yards.
Oh yeah. Yeah,
you're running across the street.
Uh-huh. Oh yeah, cuz we used to just really quick. We used to live on a cul-de-sac.
Yeah, and so not a lot of traffic.
Yeah, not a lot of traffic, and the manhunt was around the cul-de-sac. So a bunch of
Yeah,
so like, and that's a big game. Like
game. You can be anywhere.
You can be anywhere. Yard. And depending on like the how many people you got, like this is a long game.
Yeah, and it's like the adrenaline is going. I like was laying flat on the grass out in the open in the dark, and then you know the people that were looking for me walked by me, and they didn't see me, but I didn't know that. So I got up and bolted. And they're like, oh, he's there. I'm like, great. So I think I'm good at it, but I'm not good at, like, I can hide in plain sight, but I don't think that...
Has Manhunt gone the way of the lawn dart?
I don't even know what lawn dart is.
You don't know what lawn darts are?
No.
It's like a dart. It wasn't like a pointed end though, but it was, you know, it's so like you can like put it up against your hand and like it wouldn't like stab through it. It was not that sharp, but still the point of it was you'd put like a little ring however many feet away. Then you would take the dart and you would throw it up in the air, trying to get it to land point down in the circle.
Oh, really?
And like kids were catching it to the jugular, and like
I've never played that.
I got Manhunt. I've got lawn darts.
Yeah,
both have gone the way of the lawn dart.
you like people getting hurt?
Yeah, you can't. Not only can you not play lawn darts anymore, I don't think you can't buy lawn darts anymore.
I don't know.
And if you can, like they're like an old used box.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A little history on the lawn dart.
Yeah, yeah.
If you guys have lawn darts, shout out in the comments.
Yeah.
I would love to hear your lawn dart story.
Yeah. Cheers.
If you're a survivor of the lawn dart.
Cheers to lawn darts.
Cheers to lawn darts. I say bring the lawn darts back.
Okay, so Manhunt is like a grown-up version of hide and seek. So I feel like I can be good at it. Do you feel like you're good at it?
Not anymore. I feel like I was.
Okay.
I don't think I'd be good at it today.
Like just basic hide and seek?
I don't. Oh. Well, Manhunt involves more running than hide and seek.
Oh,
does.
Yeah. No. I
don't run for anything.
No. I'd be terrible at Manhunt today.
Even if it's cold out, I don't even run to the car.
Yeah. I'm asking you, do you think you'd be good at hide and seek?
Yeah, I do. I do, and here's why. Well, all depending on who I was playing with also.
Okay.
And the terms and conditions of the game.
Mm-hmm.
Because, like, depending on the scale of the game, obviously if you're a little kid playing in the house or whatever, you have, like, 60 seconds to hide.
Yeah.
But, you know, the higher the scale, the more time you get to hide.
Oh, yeah.
So the more time I have to hide... Oh, you won't find me. You won't find me.
Okay, so let's say we're playing hide and seek in the Magic Kingdom. Huge.
That's a big one.
Huge.
So here, please.
Well, we have to lay ground rules. Okay. I'll let you speak first.
Okay. This is a big to do.
Big to do.
So here's what I'm gonna say. The hider has a full 24 hours to roam the park and figure out where they're going
to
hide.
Oh, damn. That's a long time to look.
Yep.
So you need to find a spot good enough that they don't find you in a full 24 hours. No sleep.
No sleep. Well, okay. So, but here's this. You know what? Okay. Let me break this down completely. I wanted to not go too far into it just in case you had something to say, but I'm just going to say my whole thing and then
Say your piece.
The day before the game.
Day before the game.
The hider gets a full 24 hours if you want to use it. You know, it's up to the discretion of the hider how much time they use, but they're allotted 24 full hours.
Okay. 24 hours to hide?
To find the hiding spot, and then the next day they go to the hiding spot. Do you understand? The day before is just...
24 hours to find the hiding spot?
You have the full day... I don't understand what you don't understand. You have the fun.
It's excessive.
Listen to me.
Go ahead.
The day before the game, yeah, you have that whole day to look around all of Magic Kingdom to find a spot to hide for the game.
Okay.
This is not excessive. And let me tell you exactly why. One, because you're not going to use the full 24 hours. You need to sleep. Okay? Two, in this scenario... Actually, I have to ask, is the park open or closed?
No, it's just like empty park, hider and seeker.
Okay, empty park.
Like this is a...
So...
It's obviously a make-believe scenario.
Yeah, so then you have to take into account, you're not going to use the full 24 hours.
Or, I'm sorry, or you're like really, really rich and have like nothing better to do with your money or time.
Well, I can't think of anything better to do with your money or time.
Actually, I think, yeah, seriously.
You have a full 24 hours. You have to imagine you're not going to use it all. You have to sleep. You have to eat. Maybe you'll even, on the drive there, you think of a spot in your head. You go right there. You love it. You know, I don't know. But I'm giving you the full day before to hide, to look for your hiding spot.
To plan.
Okay, to plan. Then... I think it's only fair.
Yes.
Because the hider has a full 24 hours to finding a hiding spot. This is a big park. This is a big to-do. That the seeker has 48 hours.
Come on.
To find the person.
Two whole days?
John, this is a huge, huge surface area. And I don't think you're obviously
is
not
the
thinking
seeker
of all
the... sleeping?
Yes, and that's why the 2 days. But we're going to have to make a big money prize because we need more motivation to find the person. Okay, so let's say this.
$60.
Big money prize. $60.50.
Yeah.
And then, so, okay, ready?
Yes.
So it's going to be a long day for the hider, just really quick. It's going to be a bad day.
Yep.
A few more ground rules, though.
Okay.
Because, you know, there are some places that
yes.
I think we need to set ground rules on.
Off limits. Off limits. All these backstage areas, off limits.
Anywhere... Yeah, like this is where people can go. However, what is not off limits is like if you're if you want to.
Yeah, he's going to say exactly like where he's going to hide right now.
I'm just giving an example, John. Okay. Please.
60-50 on the line.
I know. This is, I know.
Okay.
I want this. Believe me.
Okay.
Say you wanted to hide in, well, I'm trying to think of, okay, I'm just going to, okay. Say you wanted to hide in Small World, because I'm definitely not hiding in Small World.
I thought you were
going to
say something.
I'm definitely not hiding in Small World, okay. So there's your hint. Okay. So, if you want to hide in Small World, you can obviously hide anywhere in Small World. Like, you can, if you want to hide behind, like, a whatever the hell, you know?
Yeah, like, behind that hippo with the, the eye that hasn't worked in 16 years.
Yeah, yeah. If
like, in the water.
If it's on stage, fair game. Fair game. And if you need help getting somewhere, I think there should be cast members at the ready to help you get there. Like,
yeah, I mean,
hold on.
Well, I don't think you should be able to go into, like, Club 33 or anything.
John, it's an empty park.
Off limits.
What are you talking about, John?
What, are you trying to hide in Club 33?
I'm just saying, what's the big deal? Because at the end of the day, it's an empty park. It's just a room.
Okay.
Can I say this really quick?
I've never been in the room. I don't know if there's multiple rooms in there. So
it's just a building. It's just a building. If you hide in Club 33, you be acting a fool.
You're found. So why not just
listen?
Nix it.
Just so we don't give away any hiding spots in Magic Kingdom at the current moment. Mm. I'm going to give an Epcot example. Okay. If I want to hide,
hold on. What if we do Epcot after this?
Well, how am I supposed to give a good example,
Use
John?
Use Six Flags. We're not hiding and seeking.
Okay.
If you wanted to
I'm at Six Flags.
Yeah.
Okay. And I wanted to hide. I'm not saying I would.
Doesn't matter. I don't.
Okay.
We're not going to do Six Flags.
Just an example. Just an example.
Sure.
If I wanted to hide on the top of the Superman, like the big drop going down, the very tippy top of
it. I would not want to be there for 48 hours.
Would not want to be there.
Yeah.
But if I wanted to hide there, I can. Fair game.
Okay.
Like,
got you.
Like, dangerous
spots. So if you want to hide on, you know, the, well,
let me say this. I'm sorry. You go.
Like, you can't hide. Can you hide on, like, the top of Mount Everest in Animal Kingdom? Like, the top of the ride? Like,
yes.
Where the tracks are not?
Yes.
So you can hide on top of the Finding Nemo, Big Blue and Beyond building on the roof.
Yes.
Okay.
You're given, the Seeker is given a full 48 hours.
Yeah, sure.
650 on the line.
60-50,
but
yeah.
60-50 on the line.
650, don't shortchange yourself.
I would never. But let me tell you, there are going to be cast members at the ready if you want help.
Sure. Yeah. Okay, there's imaginary cast member. You can get to where you want to hide. Let's just say that.
Okay.
Or for your, if you need it for your imagination.
I do.
That cast members have to help you get
cast
there.
Cast members are going to be at the
fine.
Ready. I do.
So yeah, I'm like, yes. Oh, I'm going to hide on top of Mount Everest. In your mind, you're like, they're like cast members be like, all right, pull the fire truck in and get the ladder.
Yeah.
So Andrew can climb up it.
Yeah.
They harness him. So
they have the
fall.
Funds. That it's Disney.
Yeah. And
bring in the fire truck.
That's fine. Well, if I was rich, I'd be like, we got to close the park down, so I'll give you all the money like that you would make if the park was open, which is crazy.
Wild.
People must have to do that.
Wild.
Like, if somebody rents, like, if a celebrity rents out a park, do they have to pay the equivalent or more to what a normal open day park is? It's a good question. I would say, I'll pay you that, plus I'll pay for a fire truck.
I'm not paying for a fire truck. It's Disney. They got the funds.
Okay.
Their Lightyear money will buy my fire truck.
Their Lightyear money isn't buying much anything.
So I think you got a fair idea of the picture I'm painting.
Okay. Do you have an idea of where you would hide in Magic Kingdom?
I have several ideas. And throughout the podcast, we will talk about each one. Do you have an idea? And let me say this also. If you want to ride a ride, fully functional. So like that, right off the bat, like if I'm hiding in Small World and you ride Small World, you might see me like just on accident. Like maybe my shoe is hanging out or whatever. So first thing I would do is I'd probably ride all the rides. Just eliminate that right off the bat.
Yeah, have some fun because you have 24 hours to find a hiding spot.
This is not fun.
Okay.
This is not fun.
Okay.
60-50 is on the line. That's all I'm thinking about.
Okay, so why are you riding the rides?
John, I just told you. Were you not listening?
Hold on. We're not being clear here. Are you the seeker right now?
Well, that hasn't been determined yet. I'm just talking from...
As the hider, you would ride all the rides first? Or as the 100. Looker?
Both.
Why would you ride the rides as the hider first, and why isn't it fun?
John, that part is fun.
Oh, that's what I said.
Well, I was speaking in terms of the seeker.
Okay, this...
So
here's this. We got to learn from this.
Okay.
We need to be clear with each other and for the peeps, because we're going to get confused and we're going to be confusing. Who are you?
Okay, let's start with me being the seeker.
You're the seeker, so I'm the hider.
You're the hider. So, you're going to...
I thought you were
going to
be like, so, go.
No. So, you can go ahead, ride all the rides, do what you do, if you want. I don't know, I'm just telling you what I would do.
I'm going to ride the rides for fun.
Are you going to have pen and paper in hand?
No.
I would.
Why? Well, you're not the hider right now. I'm the hider, and guess what?
Put a pin in that.
These hands are up on the rides. No pen and paper.
Okay. Go.
Let's
start with your first 24 hours looking around.
Okay. So, first 24 hours, well, the only 24 hours I have looking around, I ride everything.
Pen and paper in hand or no?
No. No pen and paper. These hands be up on the rides.
Oh, wait. I'm so sorry. Yeah. I just thought it was something funny.
What?
But what if, like, okay, so as the seeker, when I come in, I want all the pictures of you on the ride just at the front of the park. Just,
that's a good idea.
Yeah, it doesn't add anything. It's just for me.
It's funny. Yeah. I'm riding all the rides, seeing all the show, like doing everything in Magic Kingdom. Takes all day. So my
now time's running out.
Okay. So now I'm thinking, okay, there are some good hiding spots, but then there's some hiding spots that can be perceived as good. Like somebody might say, "Oh, I'm gonna go into a Hall of Presidents and you know, sit behind Abraham Lincoln in the Hall of Presidents," or something like that. Somebody could think that's a good hiding spot, but I say nay. I think that you're calling attention to yourself, because when people look on rides, I'm like, hey, I'm gonna look on Splash Mountain. What you're gonna do is you're gonna look behind all the animatronics that are there. So if you're going to Hall of Presidents, you know, you're making your rounds, you're going to go up on that stage, no question. I would argue that it's better to lay under one of the bleachers or the seats. I think people are less likely to look under there.
Huh? Wait, bleachers and seats?
The seats of Hall of Presidents.
Hall of Presidents. Okay, go on. I misunderstood.
So I think that you have a better... I'm not saying that that's a great hiding spot either, but I think that's a better hiding spot than up on stage behind the animatronic. I also think that a quick, seemingly good spot would be up in the Swiss Family Treehouse. Like under the bed in one of the, you know, whatever. To that, I also say nay.
Yeah, no, I'm going to tear that apart.
Mm.
So, just really quick, as the seeker.
Yeah.
Let me just, before you continue, just start by saying how I'm going to conduct my search.
Okay.
Take it land by land. Eliminate all possibilities before I move on. So that, with that being said, if you're playing, if you're, because Family Robinson Tree is in Adventureland, right?
Yes.
Adventureland isn't that big. Will you agree with that?
Yeah.
So if I'm looking, if I'm eliminating all options in Adventureland, which if you had an Adventureland, I can't wait to hear you where you're going to hide. It better not be Adventureland. Mm-hmm. But that you're going to be found immediately. You're going to be found immediately.
Yeah.
Anyway, please continue.
And then there's the whole Tom Sawyer Island ordeal. I think that that is a pretty good hiding spot. It's pretty big, but I think you will be found.
Oh, okay.
Yes. Yeah, so I do think that you will be found. It's not a bad hiding spot, but it's going to be one that somebody thinks, like, okay, where am I going to hide that nobody's going to look? Oh, there's all of Tom Sawyer Island. I'm going to hide there in the trees or whatever. No good. So, with that said, I'm going to...
Let's break it down, not into your final destination.
Okay.
But let's break it down into your, you know, top whatever before the final. Like what's going through your head? Like, if you had to... I hesitate to say top five because you don't have to give me five.
Right.
But like
some of the top choices.
Yeah, top choices.
Boy.
Would you like a map of the Magic Kingdom?
No. I got it. Oh, I don't need a map of the Magic Kingdom, good sir. So you have 48 hours to find me. That, you know, if there's 60-50 on the line, I feel like we should make it just an even 24 hours. You know, there's got to be some form of, you know, if you have 48 hours, that is so much time.
John, seeking is harder than hiding.
Right. So you want to get a little crunch in there. You want to light a fire. You want to be like, you have 24 hours. Not you have two full days to find them. You know what I'm saying?
Fine. 24-24.
24-24, 60-50.
Not happy about it, though.
Them's the rules, though.
All right.
Them's the rules. We've discussed no underground.
Right. On stage.
No backstage. On stage. So land, some of my top choices here.
Yeah, just like some of the first things that come to your mind.
First thing that comes to my mind is...
I feel like I know what you're going to say. I wonder, I won't say it, just in case it's like one of the things you
said. Let me ask a question. Are the lights on anywhere?
Cast members are at the ready to help you with whatever you want.
Okay, so like, you know, you're hiding... You know, on a beam on the ceiling of the on the dark part of the people mover,
right.
You can turn the light on.
You can turn the light on, and as the seeker, I can also say turn the lights on.
Okay.
Same with like Space Mountain or anything we want. Cast members at the ready to help you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is a tough one, actually.
It's not for me.
Why don't you say you're going to go around land by land and not let yourself move on until you're done.
So while you're thinking about your options, and if you want to look at a map of the Magic Kingdom.
I don't need a map.
I know you don't need a map, but it could be helpful. No. Just a visual. Okay. All right. He's sticking with his gun. 60-50 is on the line. You know that, right?
I do.
And you don't want to look at a map? Okay.
I don't want to look at a map.
All right.
All right. Let me.
So let me talk about my strategy a little bit. While you're doing your thing here. So I'm going to take it land by land, and I'm really going to exhaust all possibilities, and I'm really going to do the larger lands last, because obviously that will take up a great bulk of the time. I will most likely, I'll most likely start with Main Street, hit all the shops. I will. Okay. I'm going to, can I ask you a quick question? I know you're thinking, yeah. I know part of me bending is so you can think, but no. I have a question. Can I like just tear this place apart, or do I have to like keep it clean, keep it civil?
I say keep it clean.
All right.
I mean,
fine.
You know what?
Because if you're hiding in the clothes, I'm going to be ruffling some clothes.
All right, tear the place apart.
I'm going to tear this place apart. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the Emporium. I'm going to start ripping clothes off. And then cast members will be shouting at me from the back and be like, Andrew, it's impossible for a human body to fit in that little cubby. I'll be like, you're not the one seeking. Throwing clothes. It'll be like the Great Gatsby in the Emporium. I'll be like, throwing clothes everywhere.
Yeah.
So that's just for me, though. I know I'm not going to find it, but I just started. I got a full 24 hours. I don't need sleep. We can sleep the next day, okay? And also, since the cast members are at the ready, if I get hungry, I'll be like, hey, someone go to Casey's. Someone go to Casey's. I need a foot long.
She's like such a jackass to the cast members.
But you have to worry about the food intake. You can have anything you want.
Yeah, but you know,
you don't want to become sluggish.
You have a foot long chili cheese dog, you're going to be sluggish.
Right from there.
Where's my foot long?
Right from the foot long, I'll probably take a nap in Hall of Presidents.
It'd be like, we got all day. Ride the rides as the seeker?
100%. I would ride every ride. But I'm not having fun. And that's what I was saying earlier. This is not fun. This is a job. 60-50 is on the line. And I take this very seriously.
It's a big prize.
I can go to Chili's with that money once.
Well, like once or one and a half times.
One and a half times. This is big.
It is big.
This is, very big. So I'm going to I would ride all the rides. I'd probably skip, like, you're not, I know you're not going to be hiding in Small World. Skip. I'll be like, he's not there. And if at the end of the day there's 18 minutes left and I haven't found him, I'd be like, okay, Small he's World. There. Yeah. Okay. But no, I would take it land by land. I would start with Main Street and then I would go right into Adventureland. Mm-hmm. Knock that out because it's nice and small. And I suppose I'd knock out Frontierland and just go in a circle from there. Yeah. That sounds good to me.
Okay.
So that's my start.
Okay.
So before I continue, have you had a chance to think about some options?
So without telling you my number one, I could definitely say that a couple of things that have presented themselves as a possibility to me would be PhilharMagic has a lot of area in it, like the hole where Donald gets stuck in.
I was thinking that myself.
Yeah, were you?
Yeah.
The hole where Donald gets stuck in at the very end and falls in.
But because I'm thinking that way, you got to be careful. Well,
that's what I'm saying. Yeah. So that's not my final spot, but it did come across my mind. Another one that came across my mind is is there anywhere where the, like, hollow, like, character you could, like, fit yourself inside of, like,
like a country bear?
Yeah, that's what I'm, like a country bear or like Brer Bear. Like, is that a hollow? Like, if we can rip apart, we can go inside, right? Like, so that's a couple things that, that I'm thinking of. But I'm still thinking
That's
of that number one.
It's an interesting idea, which I actually did not consider.
Oh, which means it would actually be an effective hiding spot.
I wonder how plausible, though, because they're animatronics. It has to be a robot or something.
Guaranteed they're not hollow.
Right. So a good idea. It's something I didn't think about. So, and I wonder if, like, I wonder. I haven't thought about all the animatronics.
Can you costume up?
You can do whatever you want.
Because I'll be singing zippity-doo-dah on that boat all day.
John, if I catch you singing zippity-doo-dah, I'm not even going to say anything at first. I'd be like, I'll act like I didn't see it. But then I'll ride it again, and he'll be like, he knows.
Get me with a tambourine next to that hen that's like...
Oh, yeah. No, it's not... Please.
Do you think you would notice me if I, in costume, was the guy in the bathtub?
That's an interesting question. Because, you know, sometimes I'm looking for him and I still miss him.
Yeah, right.
So, like,
right.
I think I would miss you at least once if you were there.
Nice.
And honestly, if I was riding Thunder Mountain, I wonder if my head would even be there. Because I'd be more like looking, you know, behind the mountain peaks and whatnot. I wonder where my head would be.
But that's what the thing. Just like in Manhunt, sometimes you have to hide in plain sight. Because they're, you know, the seeker a lot of times looking in their perif, whereas the main look is their perif, and the perif is where they're looking. So if you're hiding right in plain sight, sometimes it doesn't even cross your mind.
It doesn't even cross your mind.
So you ride Thunder Mountain, and then you ride every other ride in the park. I'm in that bathtub. You're not finding me.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to stop now because... because I don't want, like, I feel the bathtub one was a really good one. I'm going to stop presenting ideas until I come up with my number one. Okay. Because I feel like I'm giving away some stuff, you know?
Okay, that's fine.
Yeah.
I'll continue on with my thing then.
Yeah.
So, naturally, I'm going to work in a circle from Adventureland. I'm going to hit Frontierland and, you know, work in that circle, ending in Tomorrowland. I am going to take a little detour to Tom Sawyer Island. I am going to devour that place. Devour it. It's going to be an ugly scene. If you're hiding there, you done messed up.
Hey, right. Oh, yeah, yeah. Sawyer Island is a...
Yeah,
is a
no. I'm going to, like... I'll be like, hey, cast member, you know, get me one of those big lights, you know, one of those big round ones. Like, you know, I'm in the cave like that.
Where's my footlight?
I still haven't got my foot long. We gave it to you 2 hours ago. But
Tom Sawyer Island is one of those things. Is like, it seems like a good hiding spot. So a lot of people probably hide there. That's why it's.
You know what else I would do?
What?
Because I'm very thorough.
Mm-hmm.
I get my snorkel out. Snorkel the waters. I'd be swimming. I'd be like, cast member. I'm not showing up in a bathing suit. I'd be like, hey, bathing suit, Emporium, now. And then they bring me the bathing suit. I'd be like, I'm changing here. Look if you want. Like, I'm gonna be that guy.
Yeah.
60/50 is on the line.
60/50.
I don't want to sound like a monster. 60/50 is on the line.
He wouldn't do this under any normal circumstance.
If it was $20, I'd be like, you know, take your time.
But this,
you know,
is not $20.
This is not
$20. It's that, over three times more.
Yeah, that couldn't buy one trip to Chili's, honestly.
No.
Yeah, not with
maybe
what
an
I
appetizer.
Not what I order.
Like an appetizer and a half, maybe.
Yeah, not what I order.
All right.
I'll be snorkeling. You better believe I'll be snorkeling.
Good.
So let me ask you.
I ain't spending a day underwater.
So you
just letting you know.
So you wouldn't check underwater?
No. I would check underwater. I would not hide underwater, I'm telling you. Even if I was in Small World, I wouldn't stand in the water. You're going to stand... You have sponge feet. You're going to get sponge feet.
John, if you know you're going to hide in the water, you prepare.
There's bromine in the water.
John, I'm made out of bromine.
He's my bro, and he's mean. So there you go.
60/50 is on the line, 60/50. Though. Can you blame me?
Mm.
Here's the thing. as you as a seeker though,
yeah,
would you investigate the water like I am?
I would snorkel.
You would snorkel?
No, I'd probably ask the cast member to drain the lake, and they can do that. And by the way, once the lake starts draining and you're underwater and you feel it drain, you'll be like, oh shoot. Oh damn.
Okay, yeah, that is
he'd be like, I've funny. Been found.
That is funny. Yeah, it's yeah. only a matter of time now. And then it goes to your head, do I just come up?
Yeah, right. Yeah. So that, you know, and that's debatable because that's technically underground. But you know what? You know
it's on the, stage, John.
It's on stage. It's on stage. It's that's allowed.
Right. Thank you. It's if allowed. You drain the water, it's allowed, huh?
Yeah. Watch out for Crocs.
I'm not afraid of Crocs. I fight Crocs on a daily.
Okay.
So anyway, once I'm done snorkeling, scuba snorkeling, I'm going to leave the water, and then you know, go through all of Haunted Mansion. I think Haunted Mansion is going to be a to-do. It's going to be a to-do.
I agree.
More so than Splash Mountain Pirates mm-hmm. and Big Thunder.
Mm-hmm.
Not more so. Well, no. I almost said something outrageous. I won't say it yet.
Okay.
It's going to be a to-do. And here's exactly why. Well, I'm not going to tell you why. I'm going to wait till it's my turn to hide, then I'll tell you why.
Okay.
Moving on. So, I'm going to just go through everything there, sparing just no stone unturned. No stone unturned. I don't think... You don't know what kind of seeker I'm going to be. Can I ask you what kind of seeker you think you're going to be? In all honesty.
To answer that question, I want to ask you a question. I want you to be honest.
Okay.
The kind of seeker I would be is so thorough. Take Under the Sea Journey of the Little Mermaid. So many ride shells. Let's say, and here's my question, I ride that repeatedly for 24 hours and that's my hiding spot. I'm on a shell. You ride it, I'm nowhere around. I'm on a shell halfway, you know, on another one. So when you get off the ride and be honest, are you going to stand there and watch every shell go by?
100%.
Okay. 100%. I didn't know if you were on yeah. that page.
No.
That
no.
is the type of seeker I'd be, though. Mm-hmm. I'd be checking every ride vehicle.
My fault would more come from, let me just give an example. If I'm back in the Emporium or whatever and I'm slinging clothes all around,
mm-hmm.
I'll get so worked up with trying to find you, like hiding within like a rack of clothes or like behind a shelf or whatever that I might like overlook like behind the cashier desk or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Just out of quick thinking, like moving on. That's where my fault would be. But when it comes down to things like the seashell, I'm going to look at every single one.
Okay. Question.
Yes.
Can I move...
Yes, but that's high risk. Because if I see you trouncing around Frontierland...
Yeah. I have chosen my... I have made my selection.
You have?
Yes.
Okay. Do you have any other, since you found your main... Do you have any other just side things?
No, but I would love to... I don't know how, like, where we're going to go with this, but I do want to hear some of your ideas. You don't have to say your main one, but why don't you give a couple if you have any? That way, we could both give our main one at the end. And if you need to think, I'll tell you what kind of seeker I'll be.
Well, so, but I'm hesitant to do that only because I kind of want to... finish your thing.
Okay, so you want to go kind of turn by turn.
Yeah, and then I just want to hear your seeker from start to end.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So, you want me to tell you?
Let me finish out my thing.
Sure.
Just so I can come to the end also with my turn, and then we'll give your final and you have nothing no other hiding spots you want to say beforehand.
I'll try to think
if you think of something,
one of the shells was one of my
thoughts, right. So yeah, if something comes to your mind, just
I'll be one of the barbershop quartet guys.
and
you'll like hear and be like, oh, they're great. You won't even know one of them's me.
You're gonna be in the Festival of Fantasy.
I'll play the piano outside of Casey's while you're eating your footlong.
Don't lie to the fans. You ain't playing no piano.
He's right. I'm not.
Imagine, though. I'm eating the footlong and you're playing the piano. I'm like, oh, well,
I know.
Okay. So, skipping Small World. You're not hiding there. Guaranteed.
I'm not there.
He's not there. Skipping it. And I'll do it. And I'll really do it.
He'll skip by
I'll it. Skip it because, one, you're not there. Two, it'll make me laugh. I think it's funny.
It is funny to be so thorough.
Yeah.
But then to just be like, he's not in there.
So I would be, I wanna touch on how I would be in Peter Pan's Flight, and then I wanna talk about Seven Dwarfs Mine Train really quick. Peter Pan's Flight, I will have the lights totally on, and I will first ride through it, okay, I'll exhaust all the queue line first and whatnot.
No doubt.
Ride all the way through it, just, you know, give a quick 1-2, and then I'm going to walk my way through it, feeling like Godzilla walking along the little town and whatnot, and another one useless to be there. I'm going to be looking inside that volcano, too. You think I won't find you in there? I'll find you in there. Oh, I'll find you in there.
Unfortunately, I'm not in there.
Well, you're not in there. If he's not in there, he's not in there.
Yep.
So, and please, I kind of hope I find your hiding spot while I'm talking.
Yeah, that's what I'm like kind of trying to.
I'm just going to exhaust all those possibilities. But if we're being honest, that's really not a big area. You're not hiding in there. Seven Dwarfs Mine Train, I want to talk about for a moment.
Okay.
Because here's the thing about that. You can be, you know, in the track and all that and anywhere on the track, which is a dangerous game to play. And that's another thing. Like, if you want to hide on a track, you can. I'm going to be riding every ride. You might, you know, if you die, you know, I'll take the 60-50 on your behalf.
Yeah, but, fair enough.
So, you know, at your own risk. But there's also the cave, the mine, and then there is the little hut outside, which I will just devour. Don't even think about it.
All with those old props from Snow White's Scary Adventure.
Yeah.
Cheers to Snow White's Scary Adventure.
You know what? Cheers to Snow White's Scary Adventure. Yes. And don't even think about dressing up because it's not going to work. Like, if you wanted to get, like, a big trench coat and, like, you know, like the... who are the two dwarfs with the... It's Dopey and...
Sneezy.
Is it Sneezy? Yeah, because he sneezes. Yeah, because he sneezes. He ruins the party. So don't think you're being smart. I'm going to be ripping clothes off.
I ain't there.
I know you're not there because...
I wouldn't be smart.
I won't be smart.
What if, are you going to check the roof? Like, what if I'm under that grassy moss?
John, I'm going to be hitting everything with a weed whacker.
Okay.
You better believe it.
Okay.
They're going to have to close Disney World for a week to clean up my mess. Actually, while I'm making the mess, people are cleaning up behind me.
Okay.
Okay. So, okay. So, then there is a storybook circus. I want to say I would be in and out of there pretty quickly. Mm-hmm. And here's why. Because it's a very large area, mostly open. There's some shops, you know, and the rides that are there, you know.
Meet and greet spot.
Meet and greet star, Barnstormer and whatnot. And it's all... Can I ask a question?
Yes.
Are you hiding in Tron?
Oh, no.
Okay, I was about to say that's not allowed.
I thought you were going somewhere else. Why is that not allowed?
It's not ready yet.
You're right. It's backstage. It's not on stage.
Yeah.
I'm not hiding in Tron.
Okay, because I would not be looking there.
How, in regards to restrooms, how well would you look?
I don't think I would look that well, if I'm being honest.
Really?
You know what? Now that I'm thinking about it, if you didn't say something, I'd probably kick in all the stalls and then be out. But I don't know what like kind of ceiling tiles there are. Maybe they're the ceiling tiles you can push up and crawl up through, you know?
I don't think that Disney has those. But you
have
know,
you, have
know?
You ever looked up in the bathroom?
I suppose I have not.
Me either.
But I would. As the seeker, but you continue.
That's an interesting question, though, because honestly, I don't think I'd give 100% if I'm being honest in the bathrooms.
Okay.
And so where was I? I was in Storybook Circus. Okay. You know where I would look?
Where?
Well, it's tough because I want to guess where you're hiding, but I also don't want to give away some of my hiding spots.
Well, see, that's why I don't know, like, right now we're playing it turn by turn. I'm not in Storybook Circus.
I know you're not in Storybook Circus. I would have found you. You know where you are?
Where?
Ready?
Yep.
Ready?
Yeah. This your guess?
No.
Okay.
I'm just gonna talk. If it comes up, it comes up. You're in Starlight Cafe. You know how the piano comes down, and a Cosmic Ray plays the piano, and then it goes back up in the ceiling. You're in the ceiling.
I am not.
You're right. You're not, because I will found you there.
Same with Country Bear Jamboree. The female bear comes down. Comes back up,
which
I'm also not there.
Which is also one.
It's a good. It's a good one. It's a good hiding spot.
Yeah, that is a good hiding spot.
Like the cast members would be so annoyed everywhere we go and be like, "All right, let's scoop me up top.
Let's go." Okay. Well, I don't think you would be. Actually, not that I'm really thinking about it. I wonder where you would be, because I almost just said I don't think you'd be in Tomorrowland either.
No.
Because you wouldn't be in People Mover. I would find you. I just think I would find you. But then again, I'm not guessing your spot. But then again, at this current moment, technically speaking, 60-50 is not on the line.
Like in this conversation?
Like me and you sitting here right now.
Yeah, like regardless of how this episode plays out, neither of us are going to get 60-50.
This is just, one of those pipe dreams. Like how you say, like, you want to own a mansion by the ocean. It's just not going to happen.
We say, like, 60-50 as, like, a prize, as something that we wish...
Yeah, like
would
the
be real,
like our
not.
Wildest dream type situation.
So this is fantasy,
and so we continue from there. Let me give a
cheers to 60-50.
Cheers to 60-50. Hopefully, it happens one day.
Hmm. 1.5 times Chili's.
Get continue. That's right.
Yeah,
give me a hot minute, and then I'm gonna give my final guess as to where you are.
Stand by, folks.
Please stand by, because if I'm... And you know what? You know what? I feel no shame. Mm-hmm. I feel zero shame right now.
Okay.
I'm going to look at a map of Magic Kingdom. Hold up. No shame. No shame.
For shame.
Shame me. Shame me.
For shame.
No shame. No shame
This is ridiculous.
Because, well, here's the thing.
Are you going to hold a map in hand as a seeker? Are you going to have a map? as the seeker?
No.
You're not going to have a map and you're not going to like cross off the places you've been?
No, I know where I've been. As the hider the day before, I'm going to have pen and paper in hand.
Doing what?
Taking notes.
You have pen and paper in hand as the hider, but not the seeker. Yeah. See, I'm the opposite. I definitely have pen and paper in hand as the seeker.
What on earth are you writing down?
Crossing out places I've been.
You know where you've been. If you go in a circle like I'm going in.
500%ed Pirates of the Caribbean, I'm cross that off.
You're going to feel real foolish when you cross that off and I'm in Pirates.
Well, I mean, either way, pen and paper or not, if I miss you, I miss you.
Well, I'm just saying you would look less foolish if it was not pen and paper in hand.
Okay.
Yeah, let me just say that. And you know what? I'm going to... So, here's why you need to look at a map. Because you're missing out on a lot here.
How do you know?
Because here's what I'm talking. I'm talking about the park is within... I'm going to say the park within the train tracks that go around the park.
Yeah.
There's a lot of land. There's a lot of land.
Right.
Are you going to cross off all that land?
No. I'm going to cross off the attractions so that I don't revisit by accident. It's a long day.
I know it's a long day. Okay. So let me... Okay. Let's see here. I think you're going to be somewhere... You're not... I don't think you're going to be in a main attraction. I don't think you would do that. I think your head is somewhere more obscure. You know where I think you are?
Where?
I think you're in Enchanted Tales with Belle.
I am not. Good guess.
Where are you?
You want me to tell you where I am?
Yes.
I thought I kind of gave myself away a little bit when I asked you if I could move. I'm moving. Hey, I'm going to give you a hint. I'm moving, but I'm staying in the same spot.
Was I right when I said you're not on a main attraction?
No. What, like, what do you mean by main attraction? Like, what's a main attraction to you? Because like story time with Belle is a main, it's an attraction. Like what?
That is not a main attraction.
Like somewhere... like is clarify. Like is Country Bear Jamboree a main attraction?
Somewhere where you would consider getting a fast pass for.
No, I'm not on a fast pass worthy attraction. No,
you're in Winnie the Pooh.
I mean, I think that's fast pass worthy. That gets a long wait, so
I'm right on.
We are on different wavelengths there.
I'm right on Winnie the Pooh. What are you fast passing that for?
No. That line gets long. I don't know where you've been, but anyway, not on Winnie the Pooh.
Okay. Could you tell me what land you're in?
Well, can you guess the land?
You're in Tomorrowland.
I am in Tomorrowland.
Because it's the land I said you're not.
And you said that, but like I had chosen my spot before you said that. Mm-hmm. So that did not influence where I was.
I believe you. I believe you.
So straight up, you're not batting a thousand.
So you're moving, but you're not moving.
I'm moving.
You're moving.
But I'm staying in the same
spot.
You're
staying in the same spot. You're in Carousel Progress.
I am. You feeling me?
Hold on. Me? Hold on.
Okay.
Hold on now. But where in Carousel of Progress? So you chose a specific scene to hide in. I'm guessing you're not hiding in the chairs. You're on a scene, so you're moving. But you're moving is the ride.
Yeah.
But you're stationary.
So let me ask a question. As it's just the two of us and the cast members in the park, rides are going when you go on them.
Yes.
So Carousel of Progress is not moving when you're not on it.
Right.
So I'm in the room next to the main room where you enter. So when you enter, you're not seeing me.
Right.
So we are never in the same room. And then if you keep going on the ride, let's say like you exit and try to go into another room, I move rooms during a scene change and go into another room. I will make sure that I'm never in the same room as you. That's my hiding spot.
I don't think that's going to work.
We'll see. If you didn't know that, if you went into Tomorrowland, and I know you would go into Tomorrowland saying, John's probably not in Tomorrowland, because you said it.
I don't remember
you're
saying
gonna
that.
Ride,
roll back the tapes.
You're going to ride Carousel of Progress. You're going to look through all the scenes. You're going to tear it up. Then you're going to check it off the list and go. You're not going to ride it twice. Maybe you'll ride it twice.
I'm not going to ride it twice, but depending on how long the tear up takes, it might go around a few times, but and because of that, because it might take, like, if I'm like tearing up like the background of a scene and I'm taking longer a while doing so, the room's going to turn, right?
Yeah, that's why I'm moving but staying in the same spot.
I know where your head's at, and that's a good idea on paper.
Well, cause as the hider, I don't have paper.
Which is your first mistake. So my first 24 hours as being the hider, I'm going to have pen and paper in hand. Riding the rides, taking notes, maybe draw a funny picture here and there.
Okay.
I don't know. And assuming the cast members are at my ready too, as the hider,
you're ready too.
I'm going to take full advantage of this.
Okay.
And you know, sometimes I'll be like, "Give me a pen with a different color ink. Give me some different color ink.
Give me one of those green pens.
Need one of the green pens." The first thing I would investigate country bears, because I would consider going up,
yep,
in the bear that comes down swinging on the swing.
Okay,
I would consider that. If 60-50 was not on the line, and I didn't care if I was found,
yeah,
how funny would it be if you're just watching country bears? And then the swinging bear comes down, but it's just me swinging.
Yeah, that's hilarious. It'd be really funny. Just like, you know, the zippity doodah, you know.
Oh, yeah, yeah, scene.
You know, that'd be funny.
That'd be so funny.
Yeah.
So I'm so curious, though, as to how you would start. How would you start as the seeker?
So I believe that I would start. So, knowing that we can move, like starting on the train and riding the train, because there are, you know, there's scenery on the train that you can't see from anywhere else. You could see like behind, like you could see some of it on the river, the Liberty Square riverboat. But there's stuff you can't see. But like, how do I know that I'm not on this train and I drive by a scene and then you're like, you were in the train station, but now you're like walking to that scene and I'm not going back to that scene? What do you mean by like,
like
where I was moving, but I was staying in one centralized place.
So let me just say this. If I'm hiding, let me just say, if I'm hiding in the Horseshoe Cafe.
Okay.
I see you walk by, but you don't see me. I'm not going to run out of there while your back's turned. Do you know what I mean?
Am I missing something? What's the Horseshoe Cafe? What's the Horseshoe Cafe?
Oh, you'll have to excuse me.
I'm
the,
like,
Diamond Horseshoe.
Oh, I'm like trying to go along. I'm like, yeah. Like, the diamond. Okay, so yeah, you'll, right. Okay, so you're not gonna be sneaking out behind my back.
Like, I'm not gonna notice that you didn't notice me and be like, oh, let me go to a place he checked off.
Right.
You know.
Right, yeah.
I'm gonna pick my spot.
Okay.
I might move
in the vicinity,
but that's my spot.
Understood. Okay, so we're on the same page.
Yeah.
All right.
And honestly,
I only ask because 60-50 on the line.
Yeah, well, I believe you.
Okay.
I believe I found my final spot. I'm not 100% sure. I'm still thinking about it, but please tell us how you would start as the secret.
Okay. So with that said, I would absolutely start on the train and take many stops along the way. I got 24 hours and check off the spots that I check. I would be very thorough, and basically the train would act as my conduit. So I would go first stop in Fantasyland. I do my rounds, and when I'm done with like Fantasyland, Adventureland, Liberty Square, I would then go back on the train, go around, next stop in Tomorrowland. I would then go, the next stop is Storybook Circus, really.
Yep.
So you go do that, New Fantasyland, Tomorrowland, that then would hop back and finish up the track,
mm-hmm.
and then go up and down Main Street. That's how I would, be thorough. How funny would it be if you were like, just like, posed at the Sword in the Stone?
It'd be hilarious.
Or like behind the counter at like Sleepy Hollow or Friar Nook or something.
Or like I would like paint my body and like get like a giant realistic like horse costume and like stand like this on the carousel.
Yeah. That would be hilarious. So some spots that I would definitely look, I would look in the Philhar Magic hole in the back. I would look at the,
which I would consider, by the way.
Yeah. As would I. I'd look in the you know, the way I think I would look at the guy in the bathtub. I would look at the Country Bear Jamboree top. I would probably spend a good amount of time in Country Bear Jamboree. Couple times to watch the show.
Oh, well, of course.
And then the rest of the times to, you know, really, there's like, and the same with Carousel of Progress. So you got your scenes, and then they like, you know, they're on a turntable, they spin into other scenes. So there's a lot to explore there.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Story time with Belle. That's, you know, we've been on that, and yeah. We were part of it.
We were
part of the show.
I have a picture of us. We were Bell's Knights. I'll put that on the Instagram page.
Put that on the gram.
Yeah.
Follow
us on Instagram, by the way.
Yeah, Instagram.
And like and subscribe on YouTube.
The Mouse Cheers at Instagram, yes. Yeah. So we have story time with Bell, multiple rooms there. It's a great, you know, it's a pretty good hiding spot. But let's be honest, it's a building. It's kind of like hiding in Club 33, you're gonna be found. You're in a building. It's easier to hide on a ride, I feel. I don't know if you're in a ride. You know, I probably wouldn't check Starlight Cafe, the piano that comes down, because I actually had forgotten about that completely.
Oh, interesting.
So if you had hidden there, I may not have found you at all.
Interesting, because when it popped into my head, the reason why it wasn't my final destination was because I was like, but it's too easy.
Really?
So it's interesting that you would forget about that.
Okay. Because
that's another one. Like, you're up there and you feel it going down, you're like, I'm caught. Like, before you even see me. Like,
just like the guy laying in the grass in Manhunt.
Yeah, I want to avoid that feeling.
That's a terrible feeling.
I want, like, when you find me, I want you to be like, I got you. Not like, come on.
How do I get you? Like, I could just go somewhere and say, found you. How are you going to know if I found you or not? Do I have to tag you?
No, just maybe if you just shout out like exactly where I am.
Yeah, right.
And I'd be like, oh yeah, you're right. Like if I'm like, found you, Carousel of Progress, you know, right next to the oven. Or
yeah,
whatever.
But what if I'm in the room next door and you don't know I'm there and you just say, you're in the room next to me, I know you are. I'm not just going to be like, yeah, you caught me.
Well, I suppose we'll just have to work out a gentleman's agreement beforehand.
Okay.
You know, 60-50's on the line. We can't really be playing around.
Be respectful.
Yeah.
Okay, so I am going to suppose I don't think that you're on Main Street USA.
Nope.
Boom. But I would tear the place up.
You would tear the place
no
up?
No question
just
about
like,
it.
Just like I was? Like,
art.
Great Gatsby being everywhere.
Broken art. Like, I don't even need to take the art off the walls. I will.
Cast
that
members,
glass shop like, right next to it. Done.
You knock over that Cinderella Castle big
yeah,
diamond
yeah, yeah,
thing.
The 30...
And the cast members are just like...
I would take the... A big Thomas Kincaid and just like smash through some glass like shelves.
Like a frisbee.
And I'll be like, ah, oh, Andrew's not in here. Now clean it up. No.
Clean it up. You get me a hot dog.
I need an all American stat. So you're not in. Okay, so you're not in Main Street, USA. I don't think you're in Adventureland.
Oh, no. In fact, that's the one spot that I think I would debate it's the worst spot.
You are 100% not in Small World.
I am not in Small World.
Not even going
to
look.
You know what? It's sad to say it.
Mm-hmm.
But we can just both pass Small World. No problem.
Because we're confident. We're just not in there.
Confident. I am not in Small World.
And I want to say, like, okay, I'm going to go on a limb because this is a big land. I'm going to say that you're not in Frontierland. You're in Frontierland.
I am not in Frontierland.
Booyah! All right, hey, I'm narrowing this down.
Yes, you are.
So, okay, so not in Main Street. You're not in Liberty Square.
No.
All right. So that leaves Storybook Circus. We got New Fantasyland and Tomorrowland. You are not in Tomorrowland. You're in Tomorrowland. What is this?
I am in Tomorrowland.
You're in Tomorrowland. Okay. All right. So you're in Tomorrowland. That makes both of us. We both said we weren't in Tomorrowland. And you are, as I was. All right. He's in Tomorrowland. You better not be on the Speedway.
No.
Okay. All right. He's in Tomorrowland. And he is... in the Monsters, Inc. Laugh Floor building.
Nope.
He is in Buzz Lightyear of Space Command, Star Command, or Space Ranger Spin.
Nope.
Space Mountain.
Though
you're in Space Mountain, you basic.
No, though one of the spots.
Oh,
I would think about, because I feel like that there's some fair hiding there.
I guess, but the light's going on.
Light's going on. I am not. Though I'm not in. I am not in Space Mountain.
Right. You're not. Oh, so there's a meet and greet where Stitch's Great Escape used to be. You're not there, are you?
No.
So you have to be, you're not in Carousel of Progress.
I'm not.
Okay. This is like the same hiding spot, imagine.
Can I give you a hint?
Well, I'm running out of spots.
Okay.
Go ahead, give me a hint.
I'm not technically on a ride.
Not technically on a ride. This is gonna be a lot of dead air here. So we got like the people mover and the astro orbiter up top. Are you in that vicinity?
Yes.
He's in that vicinity. I think you're somewhere in that elevator.
I am. Uh-huh.
Are you on top of the elevator?
I'm on top of the elevator. Yeah. Yep. You know you'd be standing in the elevator, like, gung-ho on, like, looking through all the ships and whatnot. You wouldn't be looking up. You wouldn't be doing any of that.
Wouldn't you die?
I would work it out with the crew beforehand.
Like, take the ceiling off?
Yeah.
Would that work?
100%.
Logistically, like...
Oh, yeah.
It would still... everything would be attached to pull it up?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. I would like to point out that while I, you know, we kind of baby stepped toward this, I ultimately did guess where you were.
I do have to say, you did.
Yeah. I'm not proud of it because it took a while to get there.
You shouldn't be.
Not proud.
Yeah.
Huh. Oh, we should do this again. We should do this on.
Yeah, we can hit another park.
Yeah.
And as the parks get, imagine where you can hide in, like,
yeah,
the other parks, specifically Epcot. You won't find me in Epcot.
No.
You won't find me. People, you might think because there are less rides and, like, more open area that it'd be easier. You won't find me.
No.
No. Guaranteed. That's a podcast for another day, though.
Okay, I was wondering where you're going with that. I'm like, is he expecting, are we going into this? We have done 24 hours of hiding, 24 hours of seeking, and we are just spent.
Spent.
You know what's not spent? The 60-50. Because, unfortunately, we did not get it. And on top of that, unfortunately, it was never in the running to begin with, because this is simply...
like,
fantasy.
You know, like I said, our wildest dreams type situation.
But it's nice to know that we were both hiding very close to each other in Tomorrowland.
Yeah, it's fun. I think for the most part, we were thinking rather similarly. Yes. And you know what? I'll cheers to that.
As will I, good sir. Cheers.
I'm out.
I'm not. See ya.